الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت، ذي العزة والجبروت. الحمد لله ذي القدرة والنعم، الحمد لله ذي الفضل والكرم. الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام، عزيز لا يضام، قهار لا يرام. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. أما بعد، يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Or you who believe, fear Allah as he should be feared and die not except on the state of Islam. اللهم أمتنا على ملة الإسلام يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أمين يا رب العالمين. Asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gift us the greatest gift of all, to end our life in a state of Islam. Allahumma ameen. And we say ending the life of a believer in a state of Islam, that's the greatest gift you give for yourself. Therefore, when alhamdulillah, we had the way to recite what the Prophet ﷺ used to say, recite to remind the piety for the believer, but also to ask for ourselves, because we are in need, in a necessity of the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to die in a state of Islam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray to Allah, we make dua every day to die in a state of Islam. This life is counted days. This life is going to start one day, 2 days, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 1 year, 3 years, 50, 60, 70, 80 years, 90 years, 100 years, 1,000 years is going to end. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every soul is going to taste death. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ. You're going to die and they're going to die. It's not going to be end. ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّكُمْ ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عِنْدَ رَبِّكُمْ تَخْتَصِمُونَ. You were created for the great day, for the day of judgment. It's a test. لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Now therefore, the believer not only asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make him die in a state of Islam, but ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make him be in the way to die in a state of Islam. Because someone will not go run around and then he comes in the day of on his bed or on time of his death and he will say La ilaha illallah. It's not going to happen like that. Subhanallah, within our community, many people they passed away. Many people they passed away. And the majority of those who passed away, they didn't have anything. One of it from our community. Therefore, we don't think that the angel of death is not around, or maybe he's not working around here. The angel of death, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed angel of death for every one of us. He might be visiting you every day because he doesn't know when your life is going to be taken away. It's only when he received the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his last moment with his son Ibrahim, that he had only 16 months. Please turn off the phones. Jazakumullah. He was 16 months old, Ibrahim. He already lost Al-Qasim, wa Abdullahi, wa Ruqayya, wa Zainab. All the children of the Prophet ﷺ, he lost them while he's alive. And he has only Fatima. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gifted him with a son, Ibrahim. 16 months old and he's dying in front of the eye of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم talking to Ibrahim in this last moment saying, Ya Ibrahim, لا أملك لك من الله شيئا. Oh Ibrahim, لا أملك لك من الله شيئا. I don't have any power for you, Ya Ibrahim. I don't have any power to intercede to you. I don't have anything besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I cannot offer you anything. 16 months, Ibrahim, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم talking to him, لا أملك لك من الله شيئا. We need to think. Why the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying it? To plant in our heart that this way of Allah is the way of action. It's not that you rely on anyone else. It's the way that you build your own future. You'll build your own record. You work and you work and you work. لا أملك لك من الله شيئا. I don't have anything for you, يا إبراهيم. And he said to فاطمة رضي الله تعالى عنها, يا فاطمة اشتري نفسك من النار فلا أملك لك من الله شيئا. يا صفية اشتري نفسك من النار فلا أملك لك من الله شيئا. يا عائشة اشتري نفسك من النار فلا أملك لك من الله شيئا. The dearest to his heart, Fatima, his aunt Safiya, the dearest of his wives, Aisha, لا أملك لك من الله شيئا. I don't own anything. Abu Talib dying, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم begging him, قلها يا عم, say it, لا إله إلا الله. Say it, يا عم, at least I can argue with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You did all what you did as good deeds, but it will not be counted because you don't say لا إله إلا الله. قلها يا عم, say it, because لا أملك لك من الله شيئا. Islam is not other faith. Islam has his own way, its own identity. Islam is the way of the truth. Islam قيما لا عوج فيه, no crookedness, the most upright, the only truth, Islam. When someone comes to Islam and believe in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the way of the action. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to show us Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the power, he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, had the power to bring the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to invite the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make a night journey in no time, and to be arrived or ascended to the beyond the seventh heaven in no time. And this is the Laylat of Isra wal Mi'raj. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was going to make al-hijrah, he made it in a very hardship way, made it in a very hardship travel and journey him with Abu Bakr. And people around of Quraysh, they trying to find him to kill the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to try to find and stop the way of Islam. And ask yourself, why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't have al-buraq, that horse, or what we call horse, which is al-buraq, between, as the narrator say, between the horse and the donkey. Why the buraq didn't came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to help him, to take him from Mecca to Medina with his friend Abu Bakr? Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had the power to take him to over the seventh, beyond the seventh heaven. But when it came to the journey, he made him to walk. He made him to act. He made him to taste and to support the hardship. And to manage, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to teach us that لا يملك لك من الله شيئا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم doesn't own anything for himself and neither for you if you do not act. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it for us to be aware. If the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying it to Ibrahim, to be a way for the believer, to be a teaching for us, to be a state of mind, to be a path that the believer look into it and work for it, no one will help you. Your own father will not help you. Your own mother will not help you. No one of the closest to you, your own mate and spouse, will not help you. Your own children will not help you. Everyone will say the same thing, لا أملك لك من الله شيئا. And this is a call for the believer. to awake ourselves. Because the tendency in this society where subhanAllah, without even us knowing, things are dragging you away from the path of Allah. Things that they will attack you without you knowing. They force your eye to get and get part of your heart. They force your ear to enter and get part of your heart. They force anything around you. And if you're not awake, if it's not awake, we're going to lose ourselves. Therefore, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam saying this to Ibrahim, his son, not for Ibrahim, it's for us. If the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam talking to Ibrahim, how do you think will talk to us? He told us, Al-kayyisu man dana nafsah, the smart, the real have the full integrity, the one who work with himself. He make the accountability, call himself to account every day. What did I do today? If I die today, how am I going to meet Allah? Do I have the right answer of what I did? The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in Sahih al-Bukhari, he said, don't come to me in the day of judgment. One of you, لَأَلْفِيَنَّ أَحَدُكُمْ يَجِيءُ عَلَىٰ رَقَبَتِهِ أَوْ وَلَىٰ عَلَىٰ عُنُقِهِ صَامِتٍ يقول يا رسول الله أغثني أقول لا أملك لك من الله شيء. I don't want to find among you that they came to me in the day of judgment and the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam speaking that he came to me and tell me and he has already on his neck so he has seen like he stole or he get with no right money صامت على عنقه because everyone with his sins he will have them on his neck in the day of judgment. And he came to the Prophet, begging him, Ya Rasulullah, save me. This is Islam, it's not another faith. This is Islam. You're not saved. Or you believe for someone to save you, or someone that he came for, you know, specially to save you. It's not. You save yourself. يقول أغثني يا رسول الله. Save me, Ya Rasulullah. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, لا أملك لك من الله شيئا. I said it to my son. I said it to my daughters, and I said it to my uncle, and I said it to all my family, and I said it again because this is a manhaj. This is the way of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not change the system because you are Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not change things because you are Muslim. When you say, I'm Muslim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, okay, you be on the side. I'm going to those who are not Muslim. I'm going to take them on the side and judge them. But you Muslim, I will hide you and then enter your paradise. Doesn't work with Allah. Nuh alayhi salam couldn't do anything to his son. Ya Rabbi, faqala Rabbi, inna bni min ahli, wa inna wa'daka al-haq, wa anta ahkamu al-hakimin. He said, oh Allah, my son is from my family. And he told me, take your family with you, and you are ahkamu al-hakimin. He told him, ya Nuh, innahu laysa min ahli. It's not. And Nuh alayhi salam find himself in a great difficulty when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered him that way, he was scared for himself. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind him, إِنَّكَ لَا تَمْلِكُ لِأَبْلِكَ شَيْءٍ. You cannot own anything. This is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The wife of Nuh, the wife of Lut. مَثَلًا الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا امْرَأَةَ نُوحٍ وَلُوتٍ لم يغني عنهما من الله شيئا. They could not do anything. كانتا تحت عبدين من عبادنا صالحين فخانتاهما. They were under two great pious and righteous of our servant, and they didn't follow their path. It's not because they're associated to them as being their spouse that they're going to enter paradise. No. فلم يغني عنهما من الله شيئا. And Yaqub speaking to his own children. إِنِّي لَنْ أُغْنِي عَنْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ إِنِّ الْحُكْمُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the absolute will, I cannot intercede. I cannot do anything. And continue the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, I'll come of you. So, وَيَجِيءُ عَلَىٰ عُنُقِهِ رُقَاعٌ مُخَفَّقْ رُقَاعٌ. You know, they use the skin, the jilt, the leather skin, or any type of skin, And they write al-mukatabat. They write the contract between themselves. And people who violate those contracts, people who cheat, people who steal, he's gonna come to the day of judgment and he had that contract that he didn't honor in his hand. And he come to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and said, وَيُجِئُ عَلَى عُنُقِهِ رُقَاعٌ مُخَفَّقٌ يَقُولُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَغِثْنِي Oh, Prophet of Allah, help me today. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم will say, لَا أَمْلِكُ لَكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْكَ لَقَدْ أَبْلَغْتُكَ I have conveyed to you the message. I have left behind me the Quran and the Sunnah and I told you it's look white, clear, it's night like it's day. Therefore, you only blame yourself. And don't come the same with the shaitan. He was like tricky and smart that he made me to fall into sins. The shaitan himself, he will make his very famous sermon in the hellfire and he will say فَلَا تَلُومُونِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ مَا أَنَا بِمُصْرِخِكُمْ وَمَا أَنْتُمْ بِمُصْرِخِي Don't blame me today. I didn't have any power over you except I invited you. And you answered the invitation. That's what he did. I invited you and answered the invitation. Therefore, the believer is a call for awakeness of being serious in our path. Or being focused, because what is around us is not helping us. And no one will help you except yourself. Remember, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam cannot intercede when someone he did so wrong. Only the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam intercede for those who Allah gave him the permission to intercede. Only the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam intercede for those who had their clothes As you zahzah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, they're going to get into hellfire, but they are close. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has, you know, they did deeds, but they are close. So the intercession here comes for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to help them by asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them. That's the intercession. But when you make the way of Islam, it's only thinking of intercession and thinking about miracles. The thinking of karamat and miracle that takes to the path of the khurafat. It becomes that Islam it becomes a myth. It becomes classified in the way of mythology. Islam it's not, it's action, it's real. It's real, yourself you make your own future. Yourself you make your own record. Therefore, when the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam telling to his son, لا أملك لك من الله شيئا. Just related, subhanAllah, for today at least to think of it. A son of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, 16 months, and he talking to him, لا أملك لك من الله شيئا. And the tears flows from the eyes of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And عبد الرحمن بن عوف told him, what this, يا رسول الله? He told him, this is رحمة. إن العيل لا تدمع والقلب لا يحزن وإن على فراقك لا محزونون يا إبراهيم. He said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he's in tears. But he teaching us in this very difficult moment, لا أملك لك من الله شيئا. I cannot have anything. And therefore we saying this is a call for all of us of being responsible of yourself with Allah and being responsible of the thing that you have in your hand by doing kamal al-tabligh, by give or fulfill your rights. Fulfill your rights toward your own spouse. Fulfill your rights toward your own children. He will come in the day of judgment and say, Ya Allah, he didn't teach me anything. Ya Allah, he didn't show me anything. You comes if you will be unjust to your spouse, he will come and will be complaining to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, the responsibility for everyone that of us that he has, if you want to fulfill لا أملك لك من الله شيئا, the prayer need to be a way to help you fulfill all the rights with Allah, with your family, with your community, and for the whole people around you. That's the easy way of the responsibility and a call for every one of us to reflect in a way to make your life. You really want to die as a believer. Say yes. And I want you to take you in a way of, let's imagine. Imagine everything you do. You give life in it. If you pray a prayer today, if you pray it with the khushu', you give a life to this prayer. This prayer becomes a being. becomes a person. The prayer of today is going to be a person named Al-Jumu'ah of this day. You're going to see this prayer. You're going to see it. The sadaqah that you give is going to turn to a person. Any action you do is going to go turn into a person, into a being. It's not an imagination, it's a reality. And I'm going to give you the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The wudu that you make is not only washing. You are building. You are making your own witness. Therefore, when you think of this, the wudu you make, that wudu is going to become a person. It's going to come one day and witness for you. Every action that you do. Therefore, subhanAllah, if you are caring about your own family and you care about your children and you care about your parents and you care about your friends, care about your own deeds, put life in them. If you don't put life in salah, that salah is going to go and be witness against you. It's going to be wrapped and thrown on your face and he's saying, ضيعتني ضيعك الله. You have lost me. Al hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, he's describing a vision that he saw to tell us the way. He said, I saw a believer that he's being taken in the grave and put in the grave. And the angel coming to torture him. And while they start to torture him, the wudu, his washing of the prayer came and he saved them. He said, don't touch him. It's not an imagination, it's real. And he said, the Prophet ﷺ and a believer being taken by the angel of Al-Adhab, of the torture, they take him and they want to take him to torture him. And the Salat came as a being, as a person, hold them and stop them. And he take him and save him, the Salat. And the Prophet ﷺ, he said, there is a halaqah of Prophet. And when I saw a believer, he want to join them. He said, I am a Muslim, I want to join you. They say, no, go away. Go away. He said, and a man came, hold this man to take him and hold his hand and put him and make him to sit next to the Prophet. Guess who this man? This is his washing from the impurity. اغتساله من الجناب. And someone, he said, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I saw a man on his knees and between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, great curtain, hijab. And he's so sad that he cannot see Allah. And a man came and he take him and he go take him beyond the veil. Who this man is? His khuluq, his moral. Is his moral. And a man, he said, I've said, he's facing, trying to shield his face from the fire. The fire tried, the flame of the fire want to get him. And he's away and a man came and he hold him and he put a curtain between him and the fire. What is name of this man? His name is Sadaqah. The Sadaqah you gave. When you give a sadaqah, he's going to become a real being. He's going to be there witnessing for you. And a man was shaking from crossing the sirat, from crossing the path. And his good thinking of Allah came to take his hand and cross the sirat. And a man, he said, I saw a believer falling in hellfire. But a man came to hold him and get him back on the sirat and help him cross. This man called tears from the fear of Allah. Tears he had from the dunya are counted in a clear record that will become a witness for you to help you. And he said, a man came after he moved and passed all these difficulties. And he found the bab, the gate of paradise closed. He's so sad. But the man, he said, I'm your declaration of faith. La ilaha illallah. And he opened for him the gate to get him to paradise. Allahumma amitna ala la ilaha illallah. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fa astaghfirullah. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in tears in front of his son, saying, لا أملك لك من الله شيئا. Then when it came to the time to put him in the grave, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم teaching the Ummah that the one that he's making, the one that he's making the talqin to is his own son, young son. He said, Ya Ibrahim, when the angels they come to you to ask you, tell them, Allahu Rabbi, Allah is my Lord. Wa Rasulullahi Abi, and the Messenger of Allah is my father. Wal Islamu Dini, and Islam is my deen. And he heard behind him someone in a very heavy tears. It was Umar. Told him, what happened to you, Ya Umar? He said, Ya Rasulullah, your son, he didn't have even the time for the angel to write anything on him. He didn't do any sin, Ya Rasulullah. And you are telling him all this. What will say Ibn al-Khattabi himself after long years of angel writing on my record? After long years, and who will give me the talqin, Ya Rasulullah? You give it to your son, and who will give you this? And Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, with his tears, remind us that he will see your book, وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابِ فَتَرَى الْمُجْرِمِينَ. You'll see the book, you'll see it. And يَقُولُونَ يَا وَيْلَتَنَا مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ لَا يُغَادِرُ صَغِيرَةً وَلَا كَبِيرَةً إِلَّا أَحْصَاهَا. Woe to us, why this book is not leaving anything? Umar ibn al-Khattab, that was his concern for long years. The pen has been writing everything you're doing. Are we aware of that? You're going to see it. You're going to see it. Therefore, the tears of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, it had the expression of the believer to remind us. Won't you not, for every one of us, would you not to build this book and you see that you will have something to give you in your heart? And they finish with the great deed that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his saying, he said, and a man, when the books are flying, and this is one of the greatest moments, one of the greatest moments. There's few moments in the Day of Judgment, one of the biggest one, when you will be waiting to receive your book. When you'll be waiting to receive your book, it's going to be on the right hand or the left hand. And he said, a man that his book fell by his left side. By his left side. And imagine the situation is the end. There is no, the regret will not have. لا أملك لك من الله شيئا ولا أحد يملك لك من الله. You cannot, you don't have anyone to intercede for you except what you have in that book. Only in that book. When he came and fell at your left side, what are you going to do? And here, subhanAllah, a man came and picked the book and gave it to him in his right hand. This man, his name, fear of Allah. Your action, your deed in your heart, that is called fear of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have to put the fear of him in our heart. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our piety. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help each other on righteousness and gaining more piety. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather all of us in his house of mercy. Allahumma atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusallun ala an-nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli wa sallim وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر. وأقم الصلاة.